Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Before we jump into the video, please like and subscribe. It really helps me out and helps you know when I upload new videos. Today, we're going to be redoing an old video of mine actually on global pick lists and how to set them up, how to use them, all those things. I first uploaded that video in the early days of this YouTube channel and I have significantly upgraded my audio and video, and so this video is going to be a lot easier to watch than that one. So let's go ahead and go to the cog and I will show you how to set this up. So we're going to be doing a few things. I'm going to search for global JK. I'm going to search for Picklist and I'm going to go to Picklist Value Sets. Here we are able to set a new global Picklist value set. One thing that I do like to use as an example here is markets. So let's imagine you are a consulting firm and you have different markets that you go into. Let's say you have maybe the Tokyo market, you have a Seattle market, a New York market, a Salt Lake City market, an Austin market. These are all things that you are going to be adding to different records on different objects. So let's say on the opportunities object, you want to say which opportunity or which market this opportunity is in. And on the accounts object, you want to say what market it's in. You also want to do the same thing on the leads, on the cases. Now, instead of going in and duplicating this value set for each market in the different objects, you can set one global picklist value set. So you can have this value set for all the markets, so then you don't have to duplicate that work. I'm going to have this be that example for markets. And let's see, I'm going to have Austin, Dallas, SLC, NYC, London, Paris, let's have another one be Sydney. All right, that seems like a pretty good list. Now, of course, this is going to be different based upon the different markets, or even if you're not even using this example. I'm going to have this be displayed alphabetically because that just helps my brain to see things correctly. And I'm not going to have the first be the default value. That could make it be a lot of uncomfy and bad data there. So I'm going to hit save. All right, so we have created this value set and we can add new ones, we can reorder it. It is now in alphabetical order. We can deactivate it, and when it's deactivated, users can't use it anymore. So we have created this. We can add, up to 1,000 different picklist values. Okay, so now that we have created this list, let's go ahead and go into the object manager and create this pick list. Go to fields and relationships, hit new, and let's go to pick list. Next, fun fact, you cannot use the global pick list value when you're in the schema builder. So you'll have to do this from the object manager. I'm gonna have this field be market, using a global picklist value set for markets. And it looks like this page is done. Going to set field level security and then also add this to the page layout. So now let's go ahead and add this to one more object. I'm going to have this be on the opportunity object. And there, feel free to skip forward if you want to see this in action. Go to picklist. Next, market. All right, so that's good. Next, save. So let's go ahead and hop back into our records and go to accounts, and we can see this picklist value in action. I went to an account to details, and here we go. We do have a market value that we can set from our global picklist value. It is in alphabetical order. I'm going to have this be NYC. Save. All right, now we can go and find the related opportunities and check out the markets as well there. And it is the same list. And hit save. All right, that is how you set up a global picklist value set. It can be super helpful if you want to keep your data clean and make sure that people are only using the values that correspond and if you don't want to duplicate your work. So saves a lot of time, energy, and is super helpful. So if you found this helpful, be sure to like and subscribe. If you'd like to join the email list, you can do so at salesforceemily.com. Check out the courses down below, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.